Good morning, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me today. Today is December 23rd, 2022, and it's Friday. I hope everyone is staying warm where they are at. Currently where I'm at with the wind chill, it's minus 42 degrees. And someone didn't close the outside door to the building. It was open when I got up this morning. Late last night at 11:02 local time, PM, there by Mount Rainier, there was a magnitude 2.9 earthquake. Four people said they felt it. USGS gave it an intensity level 3. The map of the locations who felt it, they don't have it marked. Intensity level 3 means it was felt noticeably indoors, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing autos rocked slightly, vibration like a passing truck. Coming from PNSN.org, here's the earthquake as it came in at Mount St. Helens. This here is a monitor from Mount Rainier. I have two stations that I downloaded from. This one here is from the University of Washington. Here's the seismic signature as it came in. I got a magnitude 2.93. And I'll show you the seismic signature right there. All right, both of these are from the University of Washington. We have station, let's see, RCS and station LCW2. So RCS comes right from the top or close to the top of Mount Rainier. The other station is off towards the west right here, LCW2. I couldn't get these other ones from the University of Washington to even work. We got a borehole and another borehole. So this one here is from the top of Mount Rainier. Let me close this out, and I want to take a look at what was happening earlier, if I can get it. Let's pull that. Drum beats. Look at that. Magma was on the move. This was, it went for quite a while. Let's see if I can get where it started. 1600. A little suspicious. Let's bring this a little bigger. What they would call it would be, where magma is on the move. See that? And it did it for what? How long? Let's see. We got 1600 all the way to 1630. So about a half an hour. Let me make that bigger there. Now again, this is at the top of Mount Rainier. Could have been they were doing something up there. We got sound, it looks like, interfering with the monitor. It's hard to see right there. Anyways, you can see the line of melt. Let's go down here and let's see what it was showing when I pulled the files just a little while ago. Right there. There's that line of melt. And heated water, maybe pockets of magma. Very well could be, but you can see the line of melt. Not very deep. And as you know, all these volcanoes are recharging for another earthquake one day. 1600 universal hours would be about 10 a.m. I want to take a look here at this one. 7:02. This is that 2.9 earthquake as it came in at Mount Rainier. It's fairly close to the top of the summit. Let me zoom in a little bit. Right there. You can see the areas of past flows. Let's zoom in to this and see what I got. If I can see anything. Just a steep embankment, it looks like. Some people probably do not realize that these are not live images from Google Earth. This image here was from last year. It says here down at the page. In fact, it was July of last year. So let's take a look what it was showing when I pulled the files just a little while ago. What kind of seismic signature that we could possibly have. Yeah, see, long and narrow. This one here is probably tectonic. No, long and narrow. All right, volcanic with harmonic tremors. Yeah, these volcanoes, as you know, are on a watch list for eruption one day. Now, when you see a signature such as what's right here, this is when they're adjusting the monitors. Yeah, this is from them, and then we got it up over here, too, it looks like, yeah, where they are adjusting the monitor. This is not an earthquake signature. This is when, let me see if I can find it. No. Yeah, no. But there is currently a lot of shaking going on. All right, so let's go to where the earthquake was recorded at, the 2.9. Yeah, over here to the west, a little south of Mount Rainier. Back in 1989, there was a magnitude of 4.9. And we'll bring it out a little bit farther. Yeah, down over here we got Mount St. Helens, Mount Adams. Yep. This here is the live stream, what it's currently giving me. Down here at the bottom is Mount Rainier. And at the top is that other monitor. That's from Lucas Creek there in Washington. Yep. Not going off yet. Hope everyone is prepared for when it does. Mount Rainier is one of the highest, volcanic mountains there in the northwest of the Cascadia zone. I believe it has over 25 glaciers, and it's a stratovolcano, meaning it was built up by many layers of lava. The last time it had an explosive eruption, you know, it has different types of eruptions where just lava flows or where it explodes, was in 1820 and in 1850. According to Wikipedia, due to its high probability of an eruption in the near future, Mount Rainier is considered one of the most dangerous volcanoes in the world. It is on the decade volcano list. Which means, let's bring this up. Let's see here. The decades volcano are 16 volcanoes identified by the International Association of Volcanology and Chemistry of the Earth's Interior as being worthy of particular study in light of their history of large destructive eruptions and proximity to dense populated areas. The most recent earthquake was probably this one right here at 10:28 and 45 seconds that they are reporting. They're saying it was a magnitude 0.1, but you can see we got other ones that are not being reported. We got one there, and yeah, we got a little pop in there. Yeah, it goes small on me when I, okay, and then we got another, several small ones right here. You guys know that they don't report all the earthquakes. And then over here, let's take a look at this. Now this is the monitor from the creek. Yeah, more popping, more stuff going on. Let's make that bigger. Okay. And then more recently, we got a little thing there and some more right there at 14:05. That would have been at 6:05 a.m. local time. Now for the summit of Mount Rainier, this one is actually marked in red. Let's make that one bigger. All right. Yeah. Yep. Yep, long and rounded tops, harmonic tremors, and volcanic tremors. Hope you guys got a plan for evacuation. I've covered this in the past, where if there is a volcanic eruption and you have any of these glaciers that melt, you'd have a rush of water coming down. And I hope you have a plan to evacuate straight up. Yeah, because that would be the only way to get clear. Most of the flows from the glaciers, when they melted, looks like it's towards the north. Yeah. Anyways, what are your thoughts? Please put those down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. Please stay safe. And I will talk to you later. God bless you all.